Now look, Rogue Company's Weapon Mastery will allow characters like Scorch and Lancer to now be able to buy any SMG or shotgun in the entire game right at the beginning buying phase of each and every match. Even characters like Phantom and Fixer will now be able to buy each other's snipers. Yeah, you heard me right.
What did he say?
However, the question is this overpowered? Am I gonna be raging every single match because characters are using guns they should not be using? Will this new weapon mastery system actually end up breaking Rogue Company? What's going on, everyone? Welcome back. So look, you've probably already briefly heard about the leaks surrounding Rogue Company's new weapon mastery. However, I think this new system deserves a bit more than just an explanation on how it works, because this thing has the potential to really change how Rogue Company is played. Now look, a lot of you might like it, or a lot of you might want to buy warranty on your whole last setup because things might end up breaking quite frequently. Now today, I am not just going to be filling you in on how weapon mastery works, but instead I'm also going to be diving deep and figuring out if this new system truly has the potential of breaking Rogue Company. Or are we just, overdramatic? So look, we're gonna be looking at all these rogues and seeing what new weapons will they now have access to once Rogue Mastery is in the game, and seeing how those weapons will affect their gameplay, and also determining which rogue is now the most powerful in Season 2 as a direct result of Weapon Mastery. Now hold on, before we get into the video, I'm actually doing one of the biggest giveaways I've ever done on this channel. I'll be giving away 2 Cherry Blossom Primary Weapon Wraps, 1 Downtown Funk Emote, and lastly a Raspberry Swirl Melee Weapon Wrap. So look, there will be 4 different winners, and all you have to do to enter the giveaway is like this video, subscribe, and also leave a comment on my second video that I posted today right here on this channel, letting me know what's the best place for me to contact you if you end up winning the giveaway. And look, that's it. Alright, now let's get started. So let's quickly talk about how Weapon Mastery actually works, and then we will get into how this new system can actually affect gameplay. So look, the way Weapon Mastery works is like this. So once you level up a specific weapon to level 1, you will now unlock that weapon for all rogues who have access to its class. Now for an example, if you were to reach level 1 for weapons like the Mark IV or the Nightshade, both these weapons will now be available to all rogues who already had an assault rifle in their original loadout. But let me explain. So now, Dima can have the Mark IV, and Phantom is now not only locked to having the Nightshade as her one assault rifle option, she can now have any assault rifle in the game as long as that weapon is level 1. Now look, this also goes for every single weapon class in the game. I'm talking snipers, DMRs, SMGs, and also shotguns. Now, I bet you're wondering, how do you level up your weapons to level 1? Well, there isn't an official announcement on how this will exactly work. However, I can really only imagine 2 ways that it's gonna go down. Now, possibility number 1, it's identical to Rogue Mastery, being that you only have to use that specific weapon and gain XP. Or 2, there will be specific challenges you will have to complete to then level up. Alright, so now that we got a good understanding of how Weapon Mastery works, let's talk about if this new system truly has the potential of just completely breaking Rogue Company. Now, the main concerns for allowing all rogues to now have access to a lot more weapons than they have ever had before is that these characters were designed and also playtested specifically to only have their original 2 weapons. And because of that, it's very possible that due to a rogue's abilities or even perks, certain weapons can essentially make a rogue way more powerful than they were ever intended to be, making the game ultimately unbalanced. Now, what I've done is I've broken down the character list to only rogues that have abilities that affect their gunplay in some way or form. The reason why I've done this is because, let's be real, just because Saint has another assault rifle that's not his original doesn't make him on balance, and that goes for a lot of other rogues. However, the rogues who are directly affected by weapon mastery are Mac, Scorch, Lancer, Dallas, and Fixer. So look, Mac will now have access to all LMGs and SMGs, Scorch and Lancer will now have access to all SMGs and shotguns, Dallas will now have access to all DMRs and assault rifles, and finally, Fixer will now have access to all snipers and DMRs. Well, that's all great and all, but what does that really mean in terms of how does this affect gameplay? So look, I seriously sat down for a while and really thought about this, and honestly, the only rogues where weapon mastery actually makes a significant difference in balancing is only going to be between Lancer and Scorch. I mean, let's think about it for a minute. Lancer can now use her passive ability with any SMG or shotgun in the game. She can now unlock the SKL shotty and can do some serious damage, being that all she has to do to reload the damn thing is a quick little combat roll. And I mean, that combination can and will 100% be the next Lancer meta. Mark my words. And now look at Scorch. She basically got a buff because now she can use her active ability on the most heavy hitting shotguns or SMGs. And look, I don't know, but I just have a feeling that most Scorch mains are gonna be using the objection, because let's be honest, Scorch's abilities plus the objection's fire rate and damage, yeah, I mean, enough said. Now look, between Lancer and Scorch, I think the rogue that became more powerful due to weapon mastery has to go to Lancer. I mean, come on, that combat reload is just so powerful, especially because it's her passive ability that essentially has no cooldown, unlike the other side where Scorch becomes very powerful, but only when she uses her active ability that has a significant cooldown. But let me know down in the comments, what do you think? Who do you think is now more powerful, Lancer or Scorch? Alright, so now going over absolutely everything that has to do with weapon mastery, do I think this new system has the potential to really break Rogue Company? Well, honestly, no I don't, but let me explain. So look, the main concern with weapon mastery was about rogues using weapons that aren't a part of their original loadout. However, I'm kinda already used to this. I play a lot of strikeouts, and that kind of stuff happens literally every single game, all the damn time. And at no point do I think that strikeout is just completely broken. However, I do think at some point there are going to be some gun nerfs here and there, but that's honestly it. At this point in time, I'm viewing weapon mastery as just something else that players can really sink their teeth into and just grind and have a whole lot of fun. At this point, I am all for weapon mastery. However, of course, things can change, and believe me, I will keep you posted on everything that happens, not only with weapon mastery, but all updates that come along with Rogue Company. However, let me know down in the comments what you think about weapon mastery. Do you think things are really gonna change? Do you think that, you know, Rogue Company is really gonna become broken? I don't know. Let's just have a real conversation. Now that is it for today's video. However, if you want more content, remember every time I post a Rogue Company video, I will also be posting a video of me playing an entirely different game. So if you like me as a content creator, you might want to go see those other videos. But hey, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.